orchestra, somebody mentioned it in the first meeting. We thought it was funny, but I think Francis was serious. So until today, today was the first time we rehearsed with them. We didn't know it was serious until then, so we're not sure if we're gonna make it. So it's gonna be fun. It's gonna be dangerous.
I thought I would be sick of the journey by now, but so far it's still been full of surprises. And about the orchestra, like what Raymond said, somebody thought of it. But again, even though we're, you know, a small band from Diliman, we had our punk roots to begin with. Most of our songs kasi ano eh, super layered talaga. There's lots of guitars. Of course, being true blue music fans, we also dabbled in orchestral arrangements. And I think this is the first time that we are going to be able to play the songs as we intended.
The past 30 years has been full of many titles for each of us individually and even for our side groups. I think the stuff that we've learned the past 30 years on our own with these little detours, we're going to bring it on December 22, meaning the stuff that we've learned, we're going to apply it. I think we've grown as musicians. I think we're matured as performers, and this is the first time we're going to be doing this. So please join us. We hope to keep it fun, we keep it light, and pagdating sa orchestra, you can't say no to the real violins, or real cellos, or a real horn section, because nothing can beat that. It's I experienced it this afternoon. The practice, medyo tumayo yung balahibo ko because real instruments would do that. It's a really great orchestra. Mel Villena is a wonderful conductor and arranger. We'll all see it. We'll all hear it on December 22.
Personally, you know, I didn't find it that difficult naman. My only problem was what to do with all the toys, the new toys. There's like 100 amps behind us, and of course we bought new gear, you know. But as far as playing again, I think it really comes naturally, and hindi ko lang namin nagagawa is like playing remotely, you know, diba? So yeah, it's very natural.
Playing together, it's like riding a bicycle. You just get on the bike and then you pedal, and then if you get enough momentum, I think you're okay. Until you fall down, and then you cry, and then daddy, and then you ask for help, and then you get back on the bike, and then you ride. So right now, I think we're finding our momentum. We've gotten on the bike. We've removed the training wheels. We're going fast. We hope to go faster. We hope to go in one direction. All the way to December 22, 2022.
Hindi nakakapagod, pero napapagod kami physically because we're not as young as we want to be. But we can't help it. You can't help it. To, you know, when you play rock and roll, you can't just play like 20%. It has always to be 110% or it won't be rock and roll, right? So the crowd gives us something, you know, the band gives us something. The music gives us something, so it's a lot of good energy.
When my partner Monica told me that our director will be Paolo Valenciano, I got so excited, and I really want to ask Paolo, how excited are you and how exciting will be your show?
I think it's quite surreal, no, to be to be asked to be part of a project like this. And I think ever since, you know, I grew up watching concerts, watching my dad's concerts. And nung nagka, ano na, nung nagka-influx or nagka-dumami yung mga foreign shows dito, When I was watching a lot of these shows, I found out later on that a lot of the gear, a lot of the tech that they use in these foreign shows are supplied by local suppliers. So ever since then, I think it was about 15 years ago, I was always wondering how come if these foreign shows are supplied by local suppliers, how come we can't mount shows like that? So ever since then, it's always been my goal to kind of like not naman compete, no, but to at least match up with them in terms of like the quality and the experience for the audience. And I really feel that in terms of like the global stage, what we've put together for the band is something that I feel you could be really proud to know that it is Filipinos who are putting this show together. It is basically locals who are mounting this show, and it there's some pride there. No pride there, knowing na kaya rin natin mag-mount ng show that is on an international international standard. And everyone involved in the production team, yung mga the writers, the guy all the way to the cam ops, the visuals, the LED, everyone is very, very passionate about this project. So I mean, we're always passionate about our projects, no? But this one kasi syempre everyone, lahat na kasama sa project are Ian's fans, diba? So syempre kailangan para feeling namin lahat ng pinagdaanan namin as prod people, as creatives, all the projects, all the shows that we've done have led us to this moment. Whatever happens on December 22, parang things will never be the same for everyone involved. And I'm excited. I'm just really excited because everyone is really, it's very personal for everyone involved. And makikita niyo yan sa stage, makikita niyo yan sa lighting, sa visuals, sa treatments. Alam mong, very personal siya to everyone.
My question is, what is your biggest challenge operating with a high-profile band who is very weird? And what is your proudest moment in the show that you want to share without telling everybody, giving it away?
One thing that I was nervous about coming into the project was, syempre, working with the Eraserheads. I wasn't sure like what that dynamic would be like. I've worked with Divas in the past, and a lot of them have given me headaches. I won't name names. I thought that I would be working with a bunch of rock stars who would be giving me a hard time and wanting this and that. But surprisingly, it's been very easy working with the band.
And world tour is one thing that's gonna happen after this year. It will be next year, and it's something that we are so proud of. And of course, we want to showcase the Filipino talents. And Ehez is a legendary band, and I think a lot of Filipinos abroad can relate to it. And it will be nostalgic for them to see them, and it will be a way to show Filipino pride. And yes, a world tour is gonna happen. We're also going to have a docu, the making of the Huling El Bimbo, which we plan to have it exhibited in cinema, SM Cinemas, Signal, Smart Gigaplay, Amazon, Netflix. So So this is, there's a lot of byproducts of this event. And it is to showcase the creativeness and the Filipino talent.
The set, is, we work a lot on the set that it changes every week. Every week we got a text and there's a change and it's it gets better. Well, at least for us. So hopefully it's great for everybody. But we're always working on it. I won't be surprised if next week it's going to be a slightly different set. But we're always working on the set every day.
Also, I'd like to point out that we haven't played in a long while together. And we haven't played a lot of these songs ever, even when we were recording them, because they were meant to stay in the album. So a lot of the songs will be a surprise. It will be different for us. Will be an exercise for us. It will be hopefully it will be an enjoyment for you guys.
There's actually a hidden Mickey sa buong show. Raymond said sa ibang interview, only the hardcore fans will decipher. Nakita namin kanina yung preview presentation ni Direk. Parang wow! Sa maliit na screen pa lang, it's mind-boggling.
The rock industry is very small and everybody supports everybody and we appreciate the work that our co-bandmates put in. And our albums are so layered when we were making it. And for the first time, we get to do all the parts live. So there's extra guitars, pianos, and earlier the strings and horns.
Yes.
That we've only managed to perform in the studio, but with the help of friends, especially like you mentioned, Mikey of Ciudad, there's Jazz of the Itchy Worms, there's Audrey of General Luna, who knows the material so well.
And Mel Villena.
So, of course, Mel Villena arranged all the string parts in most of our albums, and it's 9 albums. That's a lot of songs. It's more than 10 albums per song, so we don't even know how many songs we have. But it's 9 albums, it's a lot of songs. And we're always choosing the best one for the set. It's not the best songs that we have, but it's the best songs for this show. It's going to be sick.
You were talking about gratitude. I think another thing I'm grateful for right now during the show is the fact that I can sort of be a fan to the music, because most of the time we're just dishing it out, you know, working. But dahil it's been a long time since we've done this, parang it's good to parang step back and kumpeto nga lang maging audience, di ba? Like appreciate the lights. As a matter of fact, we requested TR to put some monitors in front of us para lang, you know, we can also enjoy the show. But syempre mahirap yun because we also have to perform. So yeah, I'm grateful that for the first time I can start enjoying the music and be a fan of our music. I don't know if that makes sense, but
yes.
Dagdagan ko yung sinabi ni Ellie na parang ang swerte ng audience na mapapanood nila kami live kasi kami hindi na nga mapapanood kami live. And in all this spectacle, yung show parang wow talaga.
Everyone's experiences are different. You know, we're happy for you and we're glad that you find our music very special and we really, really appreciate that. But, you know, of course, as people performing and playing the songs and writing the songs, it's a different thing. Sure, we get sandy sometimes when the food is late and we cry a lot when that happens. But for the most part, there are no tears, only Well, probably, yeah. Tears of joy. Because this is such a mind-blowing experience, even for, you know, old gazers like us, who we thought had seen it all, you know, and sometimes you just have to pinch ourselves, are we really doing this? Can we really get this for the show? It's like a genie out of the bottle. Every wish is our command, and that's such a great experience for the band.
We play it a little different. We move a little different. We sing a little different. We play a little different. And then when it comes together, it took how many rehearsals? 5-6 rehearsals. And today we were getting goosebumps. And you know you're getting goosebumps when you do the weird, you know, the weird face, and you look weird on stage, and you look at your friend in the seats earlier, and they look funny, and they feel you look different, and it feels good, and it's more than sentimental. I don't even know how to describe it, but when it comes together, it's that good.
I realized that I miss playing Eraserhead songs. I remember I had this feeling when I was recording the songs, when I was making parts for it, recording in the studio. And it, they're all that feelings from like 30 years ago, 20 years ago. And now, medyo na revisit ko yung mga songs, now that I'm figuring out as an older musician how to perform it, I'm reconnecting with those feelings. So that's what I know right now. I'm not sure if the magnitude of the show has hit yet, because we're not there yet. We're still rehearsing. We're still getting to know each other, getting to know the songs intimately, and hopefully by the time of the show, December 22, we'll be dialed in. We'll be dialed in so much. We're going to have fun with it, and hopefully you'll have fun with us.
Today we played Light Years, and it literally is now my favorite song because of everything that sounds good and feels good. It just felt right today. So today, it's Light Years.
Sing. It's the first time I've heard live instrumentation arranged by Mel Villena. He did the original arrangements in the Fruitcake album. When we recorded it, that was Mel Villena, and I got to hear it live. I had to stop playing for a bit if I wanted to come closer to the string section and the horn section and listen and stop playing and listen, because it's my magic talaga yung ganung klaseng ensemble instrumentation. So I don't know how to explain it. It just so happens lang na nakakatayo pala yung iba nila. And hopefully on December 22, you'll experience that. Marcos!
Same. Light Years din. Parang hindi nga ako tumugtog ng mga ilang licks baka sumabit ako. Hindi na ako yung gitara ko para marinig ko sila. Parang wow.
Feeling ko magkakatuloy yun si Bali tsaka si Marcos. Honestly.
Gusto ko yung sagot ni Marcos din.
Kung nagtuloy-tuloy kami, edi walang reunion.
I have something. So no one told you that life was going to be this way.
We were very careful when conceptualizing the stop the elements, no, for each performance, and we wanted to make sure that nothing distracts, nothing takes up, nothing diverts the attention to something else. Everything that we've included in the show, except for maybe like one or two little surprises there, no, but I forgot who mentioned it a while ago. I think it was Marcos. Everything in the show, if you are a hardcore fan, you will know how everything is, you'll understand how everything is connected. So even though we have some tech here and some surprises here, it really boils down to what, you know, the new history of band, what they've done in the past, and how do we stay, how do we build on that and not like really just add, you know, random stuff. We wanted to make sure that everything stays true to the band.
Thank you.
I think everyone's gonna have a good time. We wanted to make sure that, you know, the fans are happy. And they, you know, everyone in the production also has that same mindset. That, you know, find a way to make sure the fans are happy, and then at the same time, you know, like the, some of the guys said a while ago, there are songs that they haven't done ever, and that makes, you know, I see them in the rehearsal, and it makes them happy. So I think, you know, it really is going to be a night to remember for music fans and for Ian fans.
I'll see you there to the fans. What else can I say? I guess thank you again, and thank you for the support. I really appreciate it, and yeah.
As for me, you know, I'm not too religious, but I would say that being with E-Heads is one of the blessings in my life. Thank you, E-Heads.
Para sa manonood, get a very good night's sleep. Dapat well rested kayo talaga. Get there on time, get your chargers, phones charged, and paghandaan nyo kasi mag nap time kayo dun, magpating power nap para ma-enjoy nyo talaga kasi mapanood ko nun. Naantay kami Red Hot Chili Peppers, yung mga bata at tulog nun, tumugtog sila iba. Kami, power nap. Tapos,
December 22 is 3 days away from Christmas, so remember, Christmas is about family. I have family who are flying in to watch the show that we went to put together. They're so excited about it. I am also do it. Remember to keep your family close. That's wrong. Remember to spend time with your family, because Christmas is about family, and hopefully this show that we're doing on December 22 reflects that. Because we're doing this because it's about family. We're gonna do a show, but we're also big music fans. We go watch other bands ever since we were kids. To this day, we go to shows here, little clubs. We go abroad to watch shows. We go to different countries to watch other bands and go to festivals. We want it to be a good show. We fight for things that we think that would make it a good show. We talked to Direk Pau, we talked to Francis Lumen to make the show better, which includes more portalets, more places to buy food and drinks, places for senior members of the audience, because we have parents going and uncles and aunts and lolos and lolas. There's also room for children, because we have nieces and nephews and kids, as well as friends abroad. So we fought for things, we asked for things like streaming services, so you can watch the show in TFC. Is it TFC? I want TFC. I'm sure you will find the details if you ask the proper people in the promotion. And we asked for more space in SMBC, so there's more space opening and there's more tickets, so we could get more people in to catch the show. And we'd like to thank everybody for coming here in our little press con and for your questions. And we appreciate you coming over. Thank you, everybody. Good night.